Hello traders, welcome back to my channel. So today we have a new video in the Sierra chart tutorial series. This is going to be a topic that many of you have asked me about, and it is how can you transfer a current installation that you have of Sierra chart into a new system, or also how can you move your charts that you've been analyzing and check and executing and drawing on from one computer into another. Okay, so it's two separate things that I'm gonna go over. It's a very simple process. What you have to keep in mind is that unlike TradingView, Sierra chart is not cloud-based. It is stored in your hard drive of your computer, so it's not like you can just simply open up a chart, draw a bunch of things, and then open it in another system, and you're not going to have any of those things that you made. Okay, so it just takes a little bit of a process in order to then transfer your things from one into the other. Okay, so one thing to note, and this is something that some people have done, I haven't personally done it, but some people will actually use an external hard drive and just install Sierra chart into that external hard drive, and then that way they just boot it from that external drive so they can plug it into their desktop at home, they can plug it into a laptop, etc., and just work off of that portable hard drive so that they have the same charts and settings on whichever system they use. Okay, I don't really have a need for that, so I mostly have my home desktop, which is my main installation, and then I have a laptop that I sometimes use for travel. And what I just do is the second process that I'm going to show you here, which is whatever I have on my home computer, then I just grab my chartbook file and I just transfer it into my laptop and open it there, and I'll just have all the new annotated charts just updated just as I have them in my home computer. Okay, so for this, first let's talk about how you can transfer an entire installation of Sierra chart from one computer or one system into another. Okay, and so for this, I'm going to bring in this two windows. This first window here, I'm going to put this link in the description of this video. This is the link to the whole page online for Sierra chart where they give you the official guide. So I'm going to use this steps to sort of go over this video and explain to you how I did all of this steps. Okay, and then on the right here, this is just my Explorer window on my computer where I'm showing you the location of my Sierra chart folder, which this is the default location that it will install to. It just goes in your C drive, on your C disk, under Sierra chart. And this is all the files that you're gonna have for the program. Okay, now for this, what I generally do whenever I'm doing a new installation is I'll take an external hard drive, and then all these files that we're gonna go over here from my original my main installation, I'm just gonna copy them into that external hard drive, and then I'm gonna use that external hard drive to then transfer them into my new computer, and then I'll just launch Sierra chart from there with all the new presets from my original system, and then it'll all be exactly the same one to the other. Okay, so let's start off with the instructions right here. So first, you gotta make sure, obviously, that you have the latest version of Sierra chart installed in your new system. You can find a link here, or if you're in the Sierra chart page under account management, there's a button that says software download. Okay, so just go ahead and install Sierra Chart on your new computer. Make sure you have the latest version on both of your systems, okay? To determine where the save location is, you can also open Sierra and go to Global Settings, General Settings, and you can see where on your PC this is. But like I said, in general, it'll always go into C and then under the Sierra Chart folder, okay? So after that, make sure you exit Sierra Chart on both systems. You don't have that open. And the first thing we're going to focus on is going to be your data folder, which is this one right here, okay? Your data folder is going to contain a lot of very, very important files. It has your daily high time frame data. It has your intraday data, which is the extension .scid. It has your chart data files, your chart books, which this is pretty much all your charts and indicators and, you know, lines and support resistances, whatever, Fibonacci's, anything you've drawn on your charts. This is all saved under chart books. Then your study collections. This is very important as well. I made a video on this recently. This is any customized indicator or group of studies or indicators are going to go under study collection. And I use this a lot because it saves a lot of time to just have presets saved so that you can just apply it with one click. Then it's going to save your trade window configuration. So all your bracket orders, all your default trade sizes, etc., are going to go in here, and the dynamic link library files. Okay, so all this is going to be contained in your data folder, which is going to be the first one that you're going to start with. So for this, there is a specific note here, which I'm going to talk about now. For efficiency, it is not necessary to copy files with the extension SCID from the source file to the destination. Okay, and why is that? Well, if we go into the data folder and I toggle this from highest file size to lowest, you're gonna see that all the biggest files in this entire folder are all SCID. This is all intraday data. In this case, you can see this is all different files for the quarterly contracts of the ES, the E-mini market, depending how many days of intraday data you have loaded on your charts, you're gonna need more or less quarterly contracts. And as you can see by the size, on average, each of these contracts is probably like 3 gigabytes worth of data per contract. And you can see there's probably like 15 of them here. So it's just a very, very big, it's a big file, so that's why it says to just not transfer this, just for efficiency. And whenever you just open your charts on your new installation of Sierra, you're just gonna let the computer with the internet just re-download all this intraday data, okay? So just open the data folder, never mind on this SCID, and just copy every other file that's in here and transfer that into the data folder of your new installation, okay? After that, you can see right here, it's pretty much just copying and pasting into your external drive to transfer the following files. You're gonna have Sierra 4 configurations, account for configurations, keyboard shortcuts, trade activity logs, trade account data, position data, order list, symbol settings, default study settings, okay? And all these things are just right here. By default, all of these folders and files are going to be in the installation under Sierra Chart. So you can see Sierra 4 configuration is here. Accounts configuration is here, keyboard shortcuts, are here. Trade activity logs are here. Trade order list and position data are here. Trade account data is here. Symbol settings are right here in this folder. And default study settings is right here, okay? So you're just gonna grab all of these files that is specified and just copy them into the external drive that you're gonna be using to transfer your installation, okay? And then after that, pretty much following these things as well, copy the sound files in the alert sounds folder into your new destinations. I mean, this, I don't even use this. I don't have any customized alert sounds, but I would still just copy in all of these things that it specifies. I would just copy that into the new one, just so you can have, make sure you have all the settings from your original one, okay? If you're using custom icons, make sure to copy graphics, inside graphics, there's one that's called buttons. Make sure to copy that. Again, this is something I don't use, so I don't even have to do it. And then once you have all those on your external drive, and you might, when you're transferring things in there, you might get a alert saying, do you want to overwrite files? Just click yes. Anything from your old installation that you're putting, that you're going to put into the new one, when you transfer everything into the new installation, just choose to override anything, because you're basically taking all the original files, all the files that you're currently using on your system, and moving them into the new one, which is pretty much just plain factory settings. So you want to just override everything. Don't worry about it. And then you're gonna see here, right here, open up the new installation of Sierra Chart on your new system. Then go to file, clear recent file list. This is gonna just solve any issues that there might be, any broken paths on your hard drive for the files that may be moved or don't exist. So just make sure to click that, and also make sure under global settings, general settings, that you have enabled always use data folder within main folder option. This will ensure that the correct folder is always used, okay? And so after that, pretty much all you have to do is then take the external hard drive with all of these files that we talked about. So you're gonna have all of these things, plus you're gonna have your entire data folder without the SCID files. You just take that, you select them, and you just copy them into your Sierra Chart folder on your new computer. And again, it's gonna ask you on some of them if you wanna overwrite, just say yes. And then once you have that, then just open up Sierra Chart on your new computer, launch it, and then it's all gonna come up into it, and you're pretty much gonna have an exact copy of your old, of your original platform into your new computer, okay? The one thing you may notice, and this I found, I just have to customize and tinker a little bit on my new installation, is that the graphics, you know, some of the fonts or things like that might be a bit different. So, you know, just check up on that. Your charts might look slightly, some of the presets on the new system might look slightly different, but overall, you know, all the settings and everything that you have over here should pretty much make them identical one to the other, okay? And now, the second quick part on this is, what do you do if you have two installations of Sierra Char. Let's say you have, like me, one at home on my desktop and one on my traveling laptop, and I just wanna transfer. Let's say that I've been working on this chart book where I have here all my minute charts, my footprints, etc. Let's say I've been doing some like technical analysis here on the hourly chart, and I have, you know, support and resistance levels marked and trend lines and all this other stuff. How do I just move this chart book into my new computer so that my charts look identical on both of them? Well, pretty much following, you know, what we were talking about, but instead of copying everything, all you have to do is go on your whichever system you have your most updated charts on, go into local drive, Sierra chart, go into your data folder, and then under file type, you go right here under type, just order this by type, and you can see right here that you're gonna have all this file is called CHT, and they're actually really, really small. They're just a few kilobytes each. All these files are gonna be your chart book, basically your whole collection of charts. So like in this case, you know, this chart that I have open right here is the one that is called right here. It's this one that's called tutorials. This is the one that I use to make all the Sierra chart guide videos on YouTube. So then in this case, and you know, for this, I just need a thumb drive, or, you know, you can even use a cloud storage if you use like Dropbox or anything, any type of cloud storage or a thumb drive or external drive. I just take this file, I just drag it into my external source and save it there. And then what I just do is I go into my second system that I want to update, and then I would just go into the file explorer, see Sierra chart data folder for that system, and I just move and copy and paste that .cht file in there. Is going to bring up a window asking me if I want to overwrite it, because obviously this is a file that I have on both computers, but I'm just trying to update it with the newest version. So you just overwrite it on your system, and then you just open up Sierra chart and go to file, open chart book, and you just select that specific file, and you're going to get the most updated version again in there, because pretty much by just copying that CHT file, that is going to have all your latest, you know, all the latest saved settings and symbols, drawings, indicators, everything that your charts have, the latest time that you used. If you just copy paste that file, everything is going to show in your other system. Okay. So that's pretty much it for the video. Hope this has been helpful. Again, I'm going to post the link in the description, in the comments, for the link to the Sierra chart website. If you got any questions or comments, leave them down below. And I will see you all in the next one. Take care.